Hello there. This is Ron Wills coming back at you with yet another video. Develop your best body for body game. Now, you know, I'm known for talking about body game and everything, but one of the things I've been seeing, because I'll get some guys hit me up privately, and they'll say, well, they feel like they need to, you know, put on a whole bunch of muscle. Like, they'll be in decent shape already, but they feel like they need to put on a whole bunch of muscle. Or, you know, they feel like you need to like lose a whole ton of weight and everything, or something. Only thing I would say with body game, just develop your muscles as best as possible. But some men are going to have a slim muscular build. Some people gonna have that athletic build, more athletic muscular. And then some people gonna have the big swole and all of that. And that's cool, that's cool. But see, here's the thing. It's your best body. Like, if you're a slim dude, you gotta be realistic and understand you're not gonna be that big swole dude without the use of steroids. And that's a big problem there. And unfortunately, you got a lot of people out here using some type of enhancements like that. It's like, no. Develop your best body. Or, you know, you feel like you know, you got that football player build, you feel like you gotta get super slim or something. It's like, no. See, one of the things, and this is kind of what I was talking about in the previous episode, this is along those lines. You gotta be the best for yourself, not the next man. Don't compare yourself to that person. Yeah, they're getting some play and everything, but hold up. You can get some play as well, as long as you're your best. As long as you ain't got a decent build or something, there's some woman who likes it. Now, here's the key to it all. Here's the key. You will tend, whatever your best body is, you will tend, listen to what I'm saying, you will tend to naturally attract compatible women because they are feeling your physicality. Like, I use myself for an example, right? Now, y'all see me, you know. Everybody who see me in person, they say, look swole or look like a linebacker, you know, football player. Okay, when they see me in person. The type of women who show the quickest friendliness to me, the most receptive to me, tend to be thick fit. Like, you see those women, and a lot of them on IG or something, you know, they'll have that brick house body. They'll have that Coke bottle figure. Those are the type of women who tend to naturally be receptive. And I know some people say, oh man, you lucky dog. But like I said, no, not like those slim women, no booty or something that some people like. Nah. I go either way with them. I've hooked up with some, but at the other time, sometimes they just keep walking. I'm good with that. But when I get those, like, women with, you know, nice-sized breasts, relatively flat stomach and the wide hips and ass, you know, particularly, like, the measurements would be, like, particularly in the 40s. I like calling it sitting on a 40. They like me better. Indeed, I've dealt with some of those type of women when they look like I was losing some weight or something, you know, getting smaller. They were like, hey, I got to feed you and everything. But see, that's me. The next man, he might be slimmer and everything. And the woman might be like, aunt with him. But then he might get the more petite women, like the slim petite women and everything. And that's cool. See, I'm gonna tell you what. And here's a powerful secret. All people, men and women, is conscious for some, so others, they ain't really thinking about it. But when you connect with somebody physically, that's a very important thing. When you have that natural connection, they actually talked about it in the Kama Sutra. They actually talked about it when they talk about like the elephant, the hare, and everything. They actually talked about it. Basically, people match size-wise. Because here's the thing, communication is only at best 10% verbal. Some people have said 8. We'll round it up to 10% verbal. So yeah, y'all can have that conversation or something, but then your bodies have to feel a certain way with each other. You need to have a certain amount of lust. And that tells you sometimes, like if you don't feel any, I would tell men and women, if you don't feel any lust for that person, at least on a basic basis, leave them alone. Because sometimes people try to force it anyway because, you know, they got money, status, whatever, or even that they're cute or something, or attractive. Okay. But then they figure, you know, all of a sudden the men getting erectile dysfunction and the women staying dry. That's because they don't have a basic lust. It's a primal thing. You still need to connect on that level. And now see, since it's the men's side, I would say if a man pays attention to the women who primarily, there's always an exception, but the women who primarily show interest, they always had the same thing. Because that's where I peaked. And when I look back at the women I've dealt with, they were generally in that thick fit range. I say generally, like I said, I've been with some women who were very slim and petite. Okay, that's cool. And some, I've been with some women who were bigger. But when I look at the women who click with me the quickest, that I just feel something for, and they feel something for me because they're attracted to what I'm presenting. Oh, they were in that range. Like everybody can do that. That's a little secret. That's a little secret. Like every man should say, look and like just sit down and say, okay, which women have shown a natural attraction? And not just in what they saying or what they look like in the face. What is their bodies like? The ones that come for them. Now, sometimes you get some guys, they don't like the women coming for them. Now they got to work hard to maybe change their form. But I've seen that. In fact, okay, like I've got that football player build. I remember back in the early 90s when I was going hard, running all the time and everything. There were some women who didn't show any interest and they were like, But then when I put a little bit more muscle and everything on, they were like, hey. So every single guy got to do that. But the key to it is the body, because it tells you. Your body build and who responding to it, it tells you which women are more receptive to you. Now, it tells you, like if you see, like if I see a woman with a certain body build, I already know she's gonna be receptive when I see that thick fit thing. It's never failed. I can't think of one time it's failed whenever I see that body build. I honestly, seriously, I'm trying to think. I'm like, no, every time I run into that woman, even casually, they always at least friendly. At least, you know? At least. So, and I'm saying that this is what, and I'm sharing this with you, like pay attention, which women are staring at you more, which women compliment you more. Cause even with that thick fit, those are usually the type of women who compliment me. So if you like, okay, say you like 6'1" and slim, which women are like showing the most interest in you? You know, which women are coming your way the most, you know? And then that'll tell you something. But in order to get there, you got to get your best body. You know, don't be like thinking, oh, let me hit some steroids. That's the worst thing. Don't? Or you think, oh, well, I got to do all this stuff. Or what I feel is a shame. Some people are talking about some plastic surgery and everything. Or because they actually have plastic surgery to give you pecs and calves and all that stuff. Funny thing is, the few guys who getting it, I don't see any testimony from them. And they actually hurt themselves. Because it's a deep subliminal thing. It's a deep subliminal thing. Just work on that. Then figure, like I say, figure out which women are. And then, like, really pay attention to them. And even if you one of those guys, like, there's always this argument with approach and cold approach. If you figure out which body types of women respond to your body type, you already know which women you can approach and have a great percentage of success with. You already know. You know, okay, this type of woman is usually checking out your physical form, usually smiling. Boom. It's that deep. It's like if you look at a lot of couples, seriously, think about it. Just go out. Not online either. Go, like I said, get out in the streets. Look at the couples who look like they are like happy with each other and together. And it's always, think about it. I want y'all really think about it. Don't their body types look similar? Seriously, it's very rare. It happens. You'll see a really big dude and a petite woman. Or the other way around, some big old woman. And you see that a bit more. But usually they ain't really compatible. That's some other stuff. But like the couples that are happy, And I was going to say, like, you know, big woman, slim guy. You see that a bit more, but they ain't compatible. They ain't really, it's a mother-son relationship. But we'll talk about that in another episode. But really pay attention. Yeah, shoot, go on IG, look at the couples. Look at how they look like they fit together. Like physical compatibility and everything. You know, like if the man's tall, a tall woman, it usually clicks with him better. And even like some guy, men of short stature, you get a lot of guys complaining, but I've seen a lot of guys with short stature, they the ones be getting those petite women. The ones who ain't tripping, they just get a smaller woman. It's like, and you know, for guys talking about the wall and stuff, those petite women tend not to really hit the wall as hard. You know, it'd be slightly at best. So, but it's the physical compatibility. Physical compatibility, and that's one of the that's a big thing. But in order to get there, you got to develop your best body, not somebody else's. Don't be injecting some stuff. Don't be getting any surgery. Your best body. Just have your best form, and seriously pay attention who's responding to it. Trust me. Seriously, like I said, just pay attention to couples you see around that look like they happy together. Their body language. Look at how their bodies compare to each other. Like sometimes you might see two big old people and stuff, but they happy. They like happy and everything. And there's some, I put it like this. There's some deeper stuff. There's some even deeper stuff with that, but I'll save it for later. I'll throw out the terms anima and animus and let y'all look that up. All right. So anyway, that's all I got for now. Get back with y'all later. Peace and blessings.